أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، هو تولى الصالحين، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله الصادق الوعد الأمين. اللهم صل وسلم وزد وبارك على هذا النبي المبارك وعلى آله وأصحابه وأتباعه إلى يوم الدين. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا، وانفعنا بما علمتنا، وزدنا علما يا رب العالمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم نوِّر قلوبنا بأنوار معرفتك ومحبتك وخشيتك وذكرك يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارزقنا الصدق والإخلاص واليقين وأخلاق الصالحين، اللهم ارزقنا الشوق إليك والأنس بك، واجعل قرة العين في الصلاة يا رب العالمين. اللهم احفظنا واحفظ الإسلام والمسلمين، وبارك فيهم في هذه البلاد وفي كل مكان يا رب العالمين. اللهم اهد سكان أهل هذه البلاد إلى الإسلام والإيمان، وأت بهم أجمعين يا رب العالمين. اللهم اشفنا واشف مرضانا وجميع مرضى المسلمين، وارحم موتانا وجميع موتى المسلمين، وارحمنا إذا ما صرنا إليهم يا رب العالمين، واجمعنا بهم عندك في جنة الفردوس، واجعلنا جميعا من أهل حضرتك، أهل النظر والشهور إلى وجهك الكريم يا أكرم الأكرمين يا رب العالمين. آمين آمين يا أرحم الراحمين. أما بعد، the believers، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. صبحكم الله بالخير، طبتم وطاب ممشاكم وتبوأتم من الجنة منزلا. May Allah سبحانه وتعالى accept our salah, our good deeds, and forgive our sins. Ameen يا أرحم الراحمين. Today is tafsir class. We make last one introduction, last Sunday, for Surah As-Saff. Surah As-Saff. سورة الصف من الصور المدنية. مدني chapter and you know مدني chapters and مكي chapters. There's features for each one. مكي focus on عقيدة، faith، إيمان، توحيد، and البعث والنشور، ملائكة، all that. مدني focus on social matters and solving for the needs of the community after they established the community in Medina. And other problems like Munafiqeen, Yahud, and so on. So this is the features of Madani chapters and Makki chapters. Surah As-Saff, As-Saff means line. Like we do in Salah, is called line, Saff. Sufuf, jam'aha sufuf, plural with it, sufuf. صف singular، صفوف جمع. chapter number 61 قرآن، جزء part 28. and هذه السورة، this chapter has different names. as you know chapters in the Quran has multi names، but there is common and famous name and under that different names. Among that, Surah As-Saff. Surah As-Saff called As-Saff, wa Surah Al-Hawariyin, wa Surah Musa, wa Surah Isa. Why? Because Allah mentioned these names inside the chapter, Surah As-Saff. That mentioned by Imam Sayyuti fi kitabih al-Itqan. Wa kadhalika Al-Tahir ibn Ashur in his book Al-Tahrir wa Al-Tanwir. Start with التسبيح. سبح. التسبيح. Glorify. Glorification Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. التسبيح means in Arabic التنزيه. التنزيه means to believe that Allah, the Creator, free from any kind of imperfection. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves تسبيح so much. الملائكة، الملأ الأعلى، make تسبيح. الملائكة between earth and heavens make تسبيح. الملائكة on earth make تسبيح. everything in the globe, السماوات, skies, heavens, and earth, and every being, birds, fish, everything, say Subhanallah. Means confirmation and assuring Allah is free from any imperfection that mankind claim about Him. Subhanallah. He say God, Son of God, that's imperfection. They say three, Trinity, that's imperfection. They say God is like body, like human being, that's imperfection. That's imperfection. They speak about the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they remove Isma from them, like Yahud, Judaism. Judaism believe that prophets didn't have Isma, that against Tawheed. Yes, among the Tawheed of believers, of true Tawheed, sound Tawheed, we believe that Isma means protection. Protection from doing bad, minor or major sins concerning prophets. Protected from that. But in Judaism, no. Prophets can do, ayazan billah, minor and major even, major sins. That's against Tawheed. So all that in Islam, we reject it and say Subhanallah, means Allah, free from that. And what he mentioned, like angels, they mentioned angels that female, banatullah, daughters of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, females. They mentioned that Jesus is Son of Allah, Son of God. All that imperfection. Alhamdulillah, ni'mat al-Islam. Wa kafa biha ni'ma. So subhanallah, tasbih come in the Quran, different forms. Sabbah, like here, this past tense. Yusabbihu, present and future. Sabbih, imperative or order, mandate. Subhanallah, sighat mubalagh. So all that means, the ulama mentioned that means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala receive tasbih in all times, in the past, in the present, in the future, all of that. يُسَبِّحُ لَهُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Everything in heavens, in earth, make tasbih to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِن مِّن شَيْءٍ إِلَّا يُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِ. Everything in the creation, in the globe, from seen and unseen world, make tasbih to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Here in this ayah, whatever is in the heavens and whatever is on the earth exalts Allah. And He is exalted in might, the wise. Surah tabda bit tasbih means something, mandates, instructions, criticize, gonna happen after that. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, lima taquluna ma la taf'alun. We were believed, why do you say what you do not do? What do you not do? People say and promise, but they break their promise. This is not akhlaq al-mu'min. Not akhlaq, not manners of believers. To promise and break that promise. To contract and praise. To agree and break that agreement. Sayyidina Abdul Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, the companions mentioned, when you say this, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, we believe, give your ears, because something either Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mandate or forbid. So pay attention, high attention. Pay attention to that. What's gonna happen, what's gonna say after, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. Kabura maqtan inda Allahi an taqulu ma la taf'alun. Great is hatred in the sight of Allah that you say what you do not do. It's a big issue. وَقَدْ جَعَلْتُمُ اللَّهَ عَلَيْهِ كَفِيلًا أَوْ شَهِيدًا. Yani, contracts, agreements, any, you know, kind of, you know, promise between people. Allah shaheed, witness for that. Subhanallah. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الَّذِينَ يُقَاتِلُونَ فِي سَبِيلِهِ صَفَّ كَأَنَّهُمْ بُنْيَانٌ مَرْصُوصٌ. Indeed, Allah loves those who fight in His cause in a row, as though, or as though they are a single structure, joined firmly. Subhanallah. These ulama mention al ayah has two levels of understanding, either literal meaning of the ayah, literal meaning, or hidden meaning. Literal meaning, that while fighting in the war should be one line, support each other, the soldiers, the command, everything, every individual in the fighting should be in one line and support each other, close to each other, work together against enemy. That's one of the meaning, the triple meaning for the ayah. But hidden meaning, that Allah mentioned to the ummah, all the ummah, to be one saf, to be one line, to be one unit, all the ummah, under that meaning. Wallahu a'lam. And then mention story, little information about story of Musa alayhi salam, Moses. Musa alayhi salam. وَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَى لِقَوْمِهِ يَا قَوْمِ لِمَ تُؤْذُونَنِي وَقَدْ تَعْلَمُونَ أَنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكُمْ فَلَمَّا زَاغُوا أَزَاغَ اللَّهُ قُلُوبَهُمْ وَاللَّهُ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الْفَاسِقِينَ. And mention, O Muhammad, when Moses said to his people, O my people, why do you harm me? Why you certainly know that I am the messenger of Allah to you? And when they deviated, Allah caused their hearts to deviate. And Allah does not guide the defiantly disobedient people. Subhanallah. Al-Iza harm Musa alayhi salam, come from his people. This story what come, because come after some Sahaba or some people who asked the Rasulullah salam to fight, because they stayed for a long time, they been attacked from the enemy, but no order, no allowance for them to defend themselves. 13 years in Mecca and 2 years in Medina means 15 years they receive attack from anybody, from Mecca, around Mecca, from here and there. So they asked the Rasulullah salam to, we need to have, you know, defense department, defend ourselves. How the Rasulullah salam asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah revealed for them, أُذِنَ الَّذِينَ يُقَاتَلُونَ بِنَّهُمْ ظُلِمُ وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى نَصْرِهِمْ لَقَدِيرٌ. Allah allowed for them to fight. But when allowed, some of people return back. They remember, fighting means you may be killed, and you're going to leave your wife, your children, your farm, your business for a while. So why that? So they return, some feel weak, you know, faith. They turn it back. So Allah criticized their situation and that ayah. And I mentioned the story of Musa. Why Musa? Because he received something like that from his people. So don't be like them. Don't be like them. The situation of Yahud, the Prophet Musa alayhi salam time, they ask it, but they break or broke their promise to Musa alayhi salam. العلماء mention الإذاء harm for Musa عليه السلام come in different levels. Personally, in his character عليه السلام, كريم الله, Allah talked to him. And in the دعوة, when he went to receive Torah, what happened after him? You know the story. They make a cow and worship cow. And this is God of Musa. Subhanallah. After they receive a great miracle, save them from the tyranny, Fir'aun, and drown Fir'aun from the ice in the sea, their enemy. Subhanallah. After that, they worship
go. Wow. And they said that Musa alayhi salam killed Harun, his brother, because he went with Harun and Harun died during their alone in worshipping in place in Sinai. So when they returned back without Harun, he buried his brother and do everything. They said that Musa killed his brother. His brother. Many kind of iza in da'wah. In the da'wah. In physical iza, in his character. That Imam Bukhari Sahih mentioned that narration that they used to take showers in front of the others on the sea like that, naked body. Musa don't like that. How that? You see each other like that? They are not animals. Yes, maybe animals do that, but human with aura, cover your aura. No, they don't have that haya. They don't have that kind of haya. So they take shower together in the sea. Musa alayhi salam do that away from them, alone. Go to the sea, but away from them. Take shower. No one see him. So they talk about him that Musa has a problem, physical problem. Musa has physical problem in his, you know, private parts. So he don't anybody see him. SubhanAllah. So Allah make something to show them you are a liar, people. You are a liar. What happened? Musa away from them and put his clothing on a rock. So he finished his shower and get to take the clothing to work. So the rock moved. The rock moved with the clothing and moved fast, the rock. And Musa ran after the rock, still pass in front of them to confirm you are wrong, Bani Israel. This is a fi gasad. Is a gasad, yani physical, you know, hurt for Musa alayhi salam, and Allah free him from that. That come in Surah Al-Ahzab. فَبَرَّأَهُ اللَّهُ مِمَّا قَالُوا وَكَانَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ وَجِيهًا. Another is that they hired a woman, public woman, to accuse Musa alayhi salam that he is, you know, did fahisha with her and give. And so this, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala free him from all that. So al-iza come from Bani Israel to Musa so much. Allah remind believers, Muslims, Sahaba, don't be like these people. Learn from them to away. Take lessons from the story of the previous nation. Don't be in that. Next day, again, inshallah, start next week about that. Jesus alayhi salam and his, some of his story and his message in dunya, inshallah. والله أعلى وأعلم وصلي اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين والحمد لله رب العالمين. جزاكم الله خير.